Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, little boy or girl. What would you like this year?
I want an episode of the Christmas Just Dandy Show!
So would I.
Happy Christmas!
Happy holidays!
No, it's great because now that Donald Trump's president,
I can say Merry Christmas again!
I can say Merry Chrysler again!
We can say Merry Christmas again.
That's the biggest thing. I don't know when we could stop saying Merry Christmas.
If you fucking have said Merry Christmas in the last 3 years, you're a felon.
You're a felon. You're going to jail. It's bad. Throw it away.
I don't want it.
You don't want it.
Get it out of my face. No more Christmas. All right. Well, on the docket. Jam-packed.
Happy Hanukkah, which happy is already Hondades. Over by probably, the time this will come out. Probably, yeah. But I hope you had a good Hanukkah, same. If you celebrate Hanukkah.
It was truly eight crazy nights.
Eight crazy nights.
Starring Adam Sandler. I actually like that movie.
Pretty good. Do you want to start with that? Favorite Christmas movie?
All right, so we're going to go through favorite movie.
Favorite movie.
Some holiday memories.
Some holiday memories. Favorite Christmas episode?
Yeah, back movies. Movies and slash.
Movies, TV.
Yeah.
All right.
What would you like to start
episodes?
With?
Episodes? TV. Movies.
Movies, Die Hard, Gremlins.
Gremlins, I think my favorite's probably Christmas Story.
You like Christmas Story?
I love Christmas Story.
Christmas Story Live was just one.
It was not good.
No, I was going to say this.
It was fucking, we got through about 10 minutes of it and turned it off.
My mom loves the Christmas Story movie, like loves the movie. She turned it off, like she got to a
point. I hated that it was a musical.
It's the Broadway show, not the movie. That's why everybody's like fucking confused. It's the Broadway version of
it. It was bad.
Well, it's weird that it turned in. It was like, the first one, I love how racist it is. I know the last episode we just talked about how racism was bad.
Yeah, but
but at the end they go to their Asian restaurant and then they sing like the song and it's like broken English and it's like that would never fucking fly today.
I mean, what wasn't it supposed to be in the 40s?
30s? It's back then, whatever. I don't fucking know. Yo, shoot your eye
out. Yo, shoot your eye out.
Ho, ho, ho.
I'm trying to think other ones. I like A Year Without Santa Claus.
Oh, I mean, I love those. Bam, 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 bam.
Bam. But
he's Mr. White Christmas. He's Mr. Snow. He's Mr. Icicle. He's Mr. Ten Below.
Friends call me Snow Miser. Whatever I touch starts to freeze in my clutch. I'm too much.
They're all classic.
They're all classic, yeah. Trying to think of other big movies. Elf's always good. We watched Elf yesterday. You know.
Do you remember when the four little children had a hat and they went up to a woman and they put the hat on her stomach and a baby came out and it was like happy birthday and that baby was Jesus? Do you remember that? That's how Christmas happened.
Oh, God's four little children. It was like Frosty, but
no, that's how Jesus. That's how it really happened. Mary gave birth. That's why it was a virgin birth.
Virgin
the
birth.
Hat was magical.
You heard it here first, guys.
Frosty's the true story.
Frosty's the true ruler of Christmas time.
What's his birthday? Happy birthday.
Oh, also, Nightmare Before Christmas. I take that back. That might be my favorite Christmas movie.
I'm glad I can, as I said, five fucking episodes, however long ago that was, I mean, episodes that was. I will cut the audio from the other one saying, quote, I won't mention that.
What?
You mentioned it in the Halloween one, and I said, don't you dare fucking say that.
Oh,
the Christmas
I did
one.
Say that. Oh. Well, fuck me, right? Tell me I'm wrong.
It's a good movie. Why this is... I'm doing that whole fucking thing again. But, I mean, yeah, Elf's a good one. Elf might be like that one that's, like, always on now. It might be, like, the one that's, like, the modern one.
Yeah. Which is weird. It came out, like, 2004. But it's weird that it's such, like, a classic Christmas movie.
Maybe there's... Deck the Halls.
Deck the Halls.
Danny DeVito and Matthew Broderick, I think.
Matthew Broderick. That's pretty recent.
There's fucking Christmas with the Cranks.
I like Jingle All the Way.
Which one's Jingle All the Way?
With Arnold Schwarzenegger, and he's trying to get the toy.
Okay, yeah. Is there the one with Hulk Hogan? Yeah, Santa with Muscles, that's that one.
Fucking National Lampoon.
Okay, yeah, good movie. Vacation, of course.
Then you get, like, I like all the... There's the Muppet Christmas Carol. That's probably my favorite Christmas Carol iteration.
You know, like the one with Jim Carrey that's, like, really, really recent?
The weird, like, the weird animated one? I don't think I've ever seen it.
I haven't seen it either, I couldn't tell you. I like the Jim Carrey Grinch.
Oh, I like the live-action Grinch a lot. I don't know why people don't like it. It's not as good as the original, but it's still a pretty good movie.
Yeah, well, it's not... You're talking about the original as in, like, the hand-drawn...
Yeah, like the original.
It's not, I mean, it's not bad for...
Oh, I like it. I think it's a good movie still. Still gets a couple chuckles out of me. I think Jim Carrey does a really good Grinch.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm trying to think.
That's how I like them. I'm trying to, like... You get, like, this, like, claymation. I mean, they're not claymation, but, like, yeah, those, stop, like, motion.
You know, right? The Rudolph, the Frosty, the Year Without Santa Claus.
If Santa can truly see everything, why did he not care that Rudolph was being bullied?
Because he was different, and that's why. It's okay.
Is that why?
I guess.
Like, Santa didn't give a shit either. Like, no one was exempt.
No one gave a shit until they needed him.
Fucking Rudolph, fucking deformity, your birth defect. Guide my sleigh.
Rudolph, you fuck.
Rudolph, you fucking disabled fuck.
Come guide my sleigh tonight.
I'm going to make you offer. I can't refuse.
You can't refuse. You guide the sleigh.
Is there any other, like... Does every Christmas movie, fucking any movie that takes place at Christmas, count as a Christmas movie?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, we're including Die Hard, so, yeah.
I mean, I would include Die Hard.
Yeah, I include Die Hard, normally.
Fucking... So, would you... What's your cutoff, like, if it snows in the movie? There's Jack Frost with the fucking... That one's weird. Not the one where he's the killer, but the other one.
Like, the animated one?
No, the one where he... The kid's dad dies, he comes back as a snowman. That movie scared the shit out of me when I was a kid, because the CGI is so, like...
Oh, that one. I guess. Oh, fucking... What the fuck? I just thought of it, and it's a big one, and I just forgot it.
Fred Claus?
Fuck, no.
Good, that's my exact reaction. So, like, watch Fred Claus? Fuck, no. That's how I would react if you had asked me if I wanted to watch that.
Wait, this is like a big one that we missed.
Like anything better than that?
Yeah, this is like a good one. Oh, Home Alone.
Oh, of course, Home Alone, of course. With fucking Joe Pesci.
Joe Pesci, Macaulay Culkin, the other guy.
Apparently Macaulay Culkin, any wrestling fans out there, did a spot at a, like, indie wrestling thing where he was doing the Home Alone, like, gags.
Like, that's fucking incredible.
It was, it sounds amazing to me. But, I mean, that's...
That's that.
That's something. I like that movie. Home Alone's a good
one. I like Home Alone. Second one's...
How did they, like, not... Like, I was talking about this the other day, because it happened to come up, the movie.
Yeah.
How, like, did they forget him?
They put him in the attic.
I know, but I'm saying, like, if you're a parent, and I guess since I... Like, are you the oldest kid?
Yeah.
You probably know that, like, you get to a point where, like, they only give a shit, like, in terms of, like, supervision of, like, the youngest one. So, like, I don't understand the movie was, like, in reverse. Like, I could gally get left somewhere.
They also show the, they have it when they spill all, like, the drinks and shit with the pizza, they wipe up and they have his ticket. It was, like, in with a bunch of paper towels and they throw it away. That was, like, somebody pointed out, like, movie details on Reddit.
Okay.
And they just, like, left him upstairs, and then they, like, all, the power went out, and they all, they woke up as the cars were there, so they were just like, fuck. And then the one neighbor kid came over and hopped in the car, and they counted him as, that they had enough heads, and then left.
Okay, because I did this scream, I don't feel like doing it. Not the Macaulay Culkin, like, no, the one where she's like, she, like, screamed on the... I was like, this is a pre-9/11 world. She would have been ejected from the plane if you started screaming.
You're out.
Out. I miss Grape Woman. Ooh, youch.
Ooh, that looked like that hurt.
Something's like, ooh, we'll have to check in on her. Like, oh, God. I love that
TV shows.
TV shows, you got your classic fucking specials. You got like,
well, what's your favorite? We'll start with that.
Ever? There's some like,
I know my favorite right off. Like,
really, I like the SpongeBob one, the first one, a lot.
Yeah, it's good.
I don't remember the other ones. Like, there's the one with the Fairly Odd Parents one's not too bad either. When the U.S. Christmas Every Day.
Christmas Every Day.
I mean, you're talking about shows that have episodes and then have one episode that's a holiday themed episode.
Well, something they celebrate like a holiday.
Yeah, like a Christmas or whatever.
Yeah, there's like a yes.
Is it the Proud Family Kwanzaa special? Is that the one you're hearing?
Is that?
That's a real thing. No, that's not even me like making a joke. That's dumb. That's for real.
I never watched Proud Family, but
I liked the Proud Family.
I knew it was like the good. It seemed like a pretty good show, but
so Sugar Mama is my best. Sugar Mama.
Yeah. Wasn't that the? It's the that's one of her friends, right?
His mom.
Oh.
It's the grandmother of Sugar Mama. Because it was what's face? It was her grandmother.
What was her name? Judy? Penny? Penny Proud?
Penny Proud's the kid.
The girl.
Yeah. I don't know anybody else's name besides Penny and Sugar Mama. There was the dad who looked like Eddie Murphy a little bit, but I don't know his name. Maybe it might be Arthur Proud.
Arthur Proud? V Proud? Very Proud?
Stop. Better not be. I'm surprised there's not many, like, her acronym's PP. No, her PP. No, like, I'm glad there's humor all over the spectrum here. But yeah, I hear that. If you're probably gonna say one, I'm probably gonna be inclined to agree with you once you say which one. But mine's
Justice League.
Okay, I don't think I've ever seen that, to be honest.
It's good. It's like fucking Superman brings Martian Manhunter home for Christmas, and Martian Manhunter finds out what the fuck Christmas is about.
It's all about. Okay, and isn't there a lot where it's like, this is Christmas is all about?
It's like, yeah, it's like they're hanging out with his fucking parents, and he, like, walks around at night and, like, goes to church and shit. And then, like, Flash gets this fucking talking duck for a bunch of kids and then fights with the Ultra Humanite, and then the Ultra Humanite breaks it. Then he fixes it and, like, makes it tell Christmas carols. And then, like, Green Lantern and Hawkgirl just fucking have a snowball fight and go fucking fight in a bar. Like, it's nice. It's a very nice. The whole, like, Superman and fucking Martian Manhunter shit's really nice. It's like they're like, oh yeah, we used to wrap Clark's presents in lead so he couldn't see through them. And he was like, don't you mean Santa used to wrap them? And he was like, yeah, of course. And I was like, this is fucking great. This is wholesome. That's my favorite. The X-Files one's good.
Oh, there is an X-Files one. Isn't Santa an X-Man? X-Men? He's a registered mutant.
I think he's a mutant, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. This SpongeBob one's the one that I watch like the most.
Yeah.
This Christmas feels like the very first Christmas to me. Not the second one. I don't even remember
the second.
The second one's like the puppet one. It's like claymation or whatever.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
It's newer. I haven't seen it.
The first one's when they shoot the bottles up to the surface to deliver the letters, right?
Mm-hmm. I know what I'm gonna wish for. Another piece of paper.
He's ripped it half.
Yeah, he rips it in half. And then it was, that's one of the better. That's one of the.
Yeah, that's probably a good one.
Then he shows up at the end, saying, Merry Christmas, Squidward. Oh, and he's like, Ow, my aching. So I could talk about SpongeBob all day. It's probably a good Simpsons Christmas special. It's probably the one where they get the dog. It's because Santa's little helper. His name is the dog. So.
Probably. I don't think I've ever seen it, but.
I feel like I haven't seen it either. Now. Well, I've probably seen it. I've seen so many Simpsons episodes.
As you probably have, but you still
like remember. I don't remember the Simpsons episodes in vivid detail as I do the SpongeBob episode.
Yeah.
Sir Rugrats? Hanukkah, probably.
Hanukkah. I think they just have, like, a holiday episode. So.
Yeah, because Dee Dee's Jewish?
One of them's Jewish.
Yeah, the somebody's grandfather's Jewish, but not, not him.
Yeah, not him, it's, the other one.
The other side of the family.
Yeah.
Grandfather. He's, like, stereotypically Jewish.
Very Jewish.
Yeah. He's, like, Jewish all the time. Not that, like, you turn it on and off, but, like...
It's like a light switch, but with religion.
Yeah. Oh, that's something.
Jew on, Jew off. The Jewer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no, there is one, because then they reenact the Hanukkah thing with the eight oil, days of oil or whatever. I've seen that, now I remember it. That's in a post-Kimmy world.
Yeah. Oh, so it's like a newer one. I feel like there's probably a good Hey Arnold one.
Probably.
But.
Arnold!
Hey Arnold! Hey Arnold!
You're like, go to fuck to sleep. Like, why are you wandering like, why a fucking there... alleyway in the middle of the night, you fucking deformed fuck.
You deformed fucker.
Go to fuck to sleep. Keep it down. You would be shocked. Did I tell you that? I said, would you watch a Hey Arnold reboot where it's Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Hell yeah. Hey Gerald.
Oh god.
Hell yeah, do not treat me like this.
They get together finally in Jungle Movie.
I didn't see it!
I couldn't see it either. I just know that that's true.
So are they going to make a sixth season?
No, that was it. What? Was it farewell? He finds his parents, and that's it.
Spoilers! Yeah, I'm assuming he's gonna find his parents.
It's super old now.
It'd be too fucking morbid to find him dead in the fucking jungle.
Oh, is that why they went to the jungle?
I wasn't sure. Yeah, they were still in the jungle. That was like the last episode.
I wasn't sure if it was like the Stew Pickles thing where he endangers his whole family by like making them go into the woods.
Like, no, that's like where his fucking parents were to like.
What's the name of that movie?
Rugrats? The Rugrat movie?
No, it's like the Rugberries. What was it called?
Oh,
Rugrats Go Wild.
Yeah. Where they meet the wild thornberries.
Yeah. I can talk to animals.
Ooh, smashing.
Wacky.
Smashing.
You're smashing.
I fucking hated wild thornberries.
I love Nigel Thornberry.
I don't find it funny.
They're disgusting looking.
They're just, I just didn't like the show.
I like Nigel's look, but the girl that's not Eliza is, it's like really like.
She looks super goth, but it like doesn't make any sense.
Or her like mouth's not attached to her face. I don't like the way it looks. Shows whatever. He talks to Donnie's like the fucking
monkey.
Ape boy.
Oh, ape boy, yeah.
Darwin's the monkey.
Darwin's the monkey.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, that's something to do with Christmas.
Favorite Christmas.
Oh, what's your favorite Christmas memory?
Favorite Christmas memory.
You ever wake up and you're like, I got it, the N64. Yes! Yes! Yes!
So does that go with like favorite gift or like favorite memory I have?
You can, if they're separate, like, or it could just be like together. Like, I don't know if you wake up and you're like, it's not what, like, I don't know.
There's just some like, I'd say it was probably like last Christmas. It was just like me, my mom, my dad, my sister, and my grandma. It was just like a really nice, like nothing super extravagant, but it was like.
Oh, it's nice to just reconnect with my family.
Not, yeah, it's like my grandma never normally comes down. Like, she doesn't like coming down to visit us.
Okay.
She likes staying in Bayonne. She lives like an hour north of us.
Okay.
So like we got her to come down for Christmas and stuff. It was just nice. It was nice. You know, we've done it before where it's like, you know, you get family, you know. Favorite Christmas memory? It's like, you know, we go to my aunt's for Christmas morning. You know, just seeing everybody. Me and my cousin got in a mimosa drinking contest one year. We'll probably do it again this year.
Okay.
But nothing really like jumps out as like the best Christmas memory ever. It's just like, yeah, I'd say like last Christmas. It was just really nice. It's like, not that there's any been a bad Christmas, but it was like a
really... Like, what's your like worst Christmas gift? Like, you wake up, besides like socks or whatever. When you're a kid, you're like, fuck. You got it, you're like, fuck.
You're like, what the fuck is this?
I have some funny Christmas memories.
Yeah, there. You go first. Let me think about
the this. One, there's a couple I distinctly remember from, there was one that where it was like, I really don't want Modern Warfare 3, so like, please don't buy me this.
Yeah.
And I just would say, like, I was like, oh, yeah, there's one thing I really don't want, and it's this. And, of course, like, Christmas morning, like, it is there under the tree. And I'm like, what is this? And I was like, you got it. Like, I'm polite. Because, like, by then I knew, like, it was
expensive. Santa. Yeah, you're like, thank you.
And you're like, oh, thanks, I guess. But, like, I was like, god damn it. Like, I knew it. Like, I didn't want this. Like, fuck. Like, you're like... Yeah, on the inside, you're just fucking crying.
And it's not even like, oh, this is nice, thoughtful, but it's like,
No, I fucking specifically.
It was a waste. Yeah.
So like that was a mess. That was one of the funnier ones. I mean, it got to the point where it was like, whatever big gift I would want, like, we'll say like Xbox 360, circa like 2007 or 8.
Yeah.
And then like I'd open all my shit and I'd be like, oh, that's it. And then you're like, oh, like how do you feel? And then you'd like get your reaction of like sad, yeah, disappointed because
it's like, oh, this was good.
And you're like, oh, wait, there's one more gift and it's over here for some reason. It's in the closet. And then, like, there it is. It's, like, the exact gift.
Nintendo 64!
Yes! Yes! I don't think I have any videos like that, but... I don't know. I don't have any, like, distinctly bad ones. Like, you get, like, clothes and shit, and you're, like... When you're a kid, you're like, what the fuck? But... nothing, like, jarringly horrendous.
Yeah, that's like, I was like... nothing really jumped out as, like, oh, I didn't like this. Or it's like, there were some... socks that were just like, it's like stuff that would be like, I definitely like, it's not that it's bad, but it's like, oh, like I wouldn't wear this, or like I'm not gonna use this.
I had a lot of sweaters the one year and I was like, I haven't worn a sweater like ever.
Yeah, it's just like, and shit, I'm like
this
that
is not gonna like, no, there weren't even like Christmas sweaters for like whatever those like parties you had. They're like real sweaters. I like was like, I'm not gonna, I don't want the trouble of like taking them back. And I'm like, I'm just, they're just going to fucking sit here. Like, these will not get worn once.
Yeah.
And I was like, I'm a very, like, despite me recording this episode in a suit, basically, in a fucking dress clothes, I basically just wear, like, nicer, not nicer, but, like, shittier clothing, hoodies and, like...
Yeah, you wear, like, button-down shirts and shit, but, like, yeah, I don't think I've ever seen you wear a sweater.
Well, it's when I'm at work, but, like, I'm, you know, my fucking, well, we're having a, it's a party I go to, like, I put a flannel on, or I, like... I don't show up like a slob. I'll put jeans on and something, but like most of the time I'm in like track pants if it's cold, shorts if it's hot, and like t-shirts. So like,
yeah,
and that's hoodies,
like, so. I've always been like, you know, with my family, it's like, oh hey, like my mom got me this, and I'm just like, oh, this is nice, thank you.
Yeah, I'm always appreciative.
I think I'm gonna return it, and they're like, yeah, definitely. We have like a fucking, that's like, oh yeah, if you're not gonna wear it, just fucking get something else that you're gonna wear.
They learned their lesson, I think. I think I'm mainly getting hoodies now, so.
Hoodies.
Yeah.
What are you, what's your best Christmas gift?
Ever?
Ever.
That's tough. I remember getting the Wii. It was new.
I was going to say the Wii.
I got a Dear Keep, man.
I got the Dear Keep. Yeah. I don't know how the fuck my dad found it.
I took forever. I actually went to pre-order with him. In the worst fucking neighborhood, like, it was a fucking car chase, like, through the fucking, like, intersection where we stopped at the light before Toys R Us, and, like, they fucking got it, it was great. I mean, I remember that being awesome. That's the one I really remember, like, after that, like, generation of systems,
like, no, like I remember,
I bought the Xbox One and PS4 myself.
Yeah, like, I got the 360, so, like, that was the last, like, fucking... system.
On Christmas, I think I'm... No, because I bought the 3DS myself for my birthday.
Like, yeah, everything else I bought myself.
And then I bought the Xbox One and PS4 the year they came out, like the 2 days, the first whatever days they were. I think it was the 17th and 19th. They were 2 days apart, and it was $1,000, basically. And that was from when I was working. So then I ended up getting this, and then I just got games for Christmas. And then the Wii U was the year that I had won... football gambling. I won like a couple hundred dollars, and I ended up buying the Wii U before Christmas came out. But yeah, so I don't think there's been one. Like, I know better now because like I come from a house with three younger kids, so like I'm not gonna ask for the Xbox One X, though I would want it.
Yeah.
But like I'm not gonna even insinuate like buy me a $550 after tax gift. When there's, like, little kids in the house.
Yeah, it's like a shit for little kids.
Yeah, so, like...
Yeah, I was gonna say Wii. It's probably the... I think I got the most use out of that system.
Yeah, probably. Like, I'm trying to think of the ones before. DS was pretty cool when I got it.
Yeah, DS was cool. Got a Game Boy
Color.
I got a Game Boy Advance, which was...
I had a Game Boy Color when they were new back then.
I actually take that back. It might be Game Boy Advance and Pokemon Ruby. I think that might have been the... Probably got the most play out of that.
Oh, you know what? The N64. I know that we've been not making fun of the kids, but, like, the references.
Yes!
I actually remember getting that in Mario 64. I think that might have been the first time I ever played games, and I probably was about 3 years old back then, and I've been playing, like, pretty consistently since.
Yeah.
I mean, I had Mario 64. I loved the shit out of that game. I loved the shit out of the Pokemon Stadium games. I played the fuck out of those mini games. I have the Mario Parties. I didn't get Smash Brothers till way afterwards. Yeah. That was the new GameCube cycle. And then, what else did I have? I had, Pokemon Snap. Love that game. Great game. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's N64 or Wii, probably. I don't think I got the GameCube for Christmas. I'm trying to think before that, because I did get the Xbox 360 for a Christmas gift.
Yeah.
But that wasn't at launch, so it was like, well,
I... Yeah, that was after it came out.
And then I got a PS3 for Christmas, like, the next year. And that was, like, when the Slim was new. I didn't have the fat one. Like, I had the smaller one.
Yeah.
I basically, like, it got to a point where I just asked for, like, one console to play. I just space them yearly, but I got to a point where I was working and I just buy them.
Yeah, you just buy them yourself.
So, yeah, I have no fucking idea what I'm getting for Christmas. I didn't even ask for anything.
A fucking, a pair of running shoes, a pair of Converse. I gave my mom Breath of the Wild to give me. It's for a Swamp Thing comic. Like, I didn't ask for a lot.
I couldn't even think of anything because all the shit I wanted ended up getting, like, middling reviews. So I was like, oh, I want Battlefront 2. And then I was like,
well, I was like, oh, I should ask for, like, Mario Kart.
Yeah, you should ask for Splatoon, to be honest.
I'm going to see. GameStop had something that I saw on TV yesterday that was, like, some crazy... I couldn't find it on the website, but on, like, the landing page of it's, like, GameStop, like, Days of Deals. It had fucking rabbits for, like, $9. Mario Rabbids.
That game was really good. I just beat that.
And I was like, fuck, I'll get that for $9. It didn't look like a ton of fun, but I feel like
I was fucking good. I actually really liked it.
I mean, I've never played XCOM before.
Me neither.
Excuse me.
I haven't either, and I thought it was great.
But yeah,
I don't even like this kind of game, but...
But I was like, oh, maybe I should get fucking Mario Kart, and then, you know, like, me and my sister can fuck around and play. So it's like... I might see if anybody has, like, a fucking...
That's one of my favorite Christmas, like, memories, too. I loved going out the day after Christmas with all my money, and I would, like, maximize the fucking deal potential. But
let's see. I'm gonna look that up later. What else is there to fuck?
Oh, favorite Christmas songs, dude.
Favorite Christmas songs.
I'll give you three choices, and you give me three choices, and then...
Let me look up my playlist.
And you... No, I'm just going to tell you three right now.
Okay, tell me three.
I'll just sing them. All I want for Christmas is you.
By Mariah Carey?
Yeah. You, baby. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. And then, I don't know. I can't even think. There's obviously, like, you got your classics, you know, like, Deck the Halls.
I'm just gonna, like, start, like, Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree, Run, Run, Rudolph.
What, Little Saint Nick?
I was going to get Little Saint Nick by the Beach Boys.
Little Saint Nick.
Holly Jolly Little Christmas. Let It Snow.
Let It Go by Frozen.
Little Saint Nick. Sleigh Ride, Winter Wonderland.
Let It Snow. Sleigh Bells Ring. Are you listening? Get that out of here.
We're going to have to buzz it out because there's,
Walking in a winter wonderland.
I'm going to say, fuck, I just saw it. I'm just, wait. No. Yeah, I'm going to say Rock Around the Christmas Tree.
Rock Around the Christmas Tree. Have a,
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just
just like the ones I used to know.
Are Switches really only $300? I guess mine was $370.
I'm going to say, I think I like the Mariah Carey one. It's a jam.
It's a great fucking song. It's an amazing song.
It's a jam. And that and Last Christmas I like too, but...
We also, every Christmas morning when we drive up to my aunt's, we listen to the entirety of the Michael Bublé Christmas album. What's two to three times, depending on traffic.
What songs does he sing?
Oh, he's fucking, I don't want a lot for Christmas.
There is just one thing.
Something like that. He sings a lot of it, like Jingle Bells. He sings a lot of it.
Oh, he just covers all the
time. It's a good, yeah, it's a really good album. He's a very talented dude.
The only Michael Bublé song I know is the one if you've ever seen the South Park, when it's the fucking South Park when they're making fun of World War Z. Have you seen that one where Cartman's scared of black people and he thinks they're all zombies, and then he has the nightmare where he's Brad Pitt in World War Z?
What?
And at the end it's like, it's a beautiful day and I can't stop myself from smiling. If we're drinking then I'm buying. You ever see that one? It's at the end. It's like, daddy, it's okay, girls. Daddy did it. Daddy stopped being racist.
Is that a new one?
It's not. It's like two or three seasons ago.
Fuck, I don't think I've ever seen that.
That's a fucking... I literally like that one because at the end he goes back and he spray paints a circle around him, and he's like, "Token fist bump, bro." And he comes in and Token fist bumps him, and then Carmen takes a gun out and shoots him. It's like, "Stood my ground, stood my ground." Everybody saw he was on my ground. That's what. Have you not seen that one? He spray paints a perfect circle around him. It's a pretty good one.
Oh shit.
That's. I guess we'll come back with a Christmas update post. I mean, my favorite thing on Christmas was always going out that next day. I know I said that already. You ever do that?
We would always do the noggin jog with, like, my track team the day after Christmas. That was our...
No, I would go shopping. Yeah. I love going out on Black Friday, so that's...
Me and my dad, there were sometimes, like, when he would, like, want to go out, like, super early. Like, we got out at, like, 4 o'clock on the day after Christmas, like, in the morning, and gotten, like... fucking yeah. Christmas decorations, like, 75% off.
I would go with, like, the fucking Christmas
one. Oh, yeah, we would go, like...
Oh, I got this other shit. Not that I missed it. Like, I was... They had a list of shit, but, like, oh, I want all this shit. Now I have all this money, like... I could do that with this year. I, like, can't really...
But it's, like, fucking, We went out and got, like, a fake Christmas tree, like, two or three years ago, and we were at Macy's, and there was, like, fucking the workers in Macy's and us. And that was it. And they had a fucking bunch of ornaments... And I got a fucking black Santa, probably about 8 or 9 inches tall, for $1. And it is the centerpiece on the tree right now.
Has it been there, like, every year since?
I don't know. It's been front and center on the tree every year since.
Good.
And it's fucking great.
I think it's a perfect way.
I was like, look, Dad. And he was like, please don't buy that. And I was like, I'm going to buy it. And mind you, I was maybe 19.
Son, don't buy the black man.
Don't buy the black Santa.
Don't buy that black man, son.
It's like, hell yeah, I'm gonna buy black Santa.
It's not the 1800s.
Son. He was like, your pop-up had an ornament eerily similar to this. I was like, hell yeah. But,
that's a perfect way, dude.
And Christmas. And the Christmas episode?
Christmas is cancelled.
Christmas is ruined.
Ruined.
Ruined?
Is there a fucking Family Guy Christmas special?
Peter! Killed Santa! Now you gotta do it. Now you gotta be Santa Claus!
I know they do a Jesus one. They do like a fucking...
Well, that wasn't the Christmas one. I'm Santa.
I watched an episode last night that was on like Adult Swim. There was fucking like... Chris was like a fucking child... predator and like chemically castrated him. It was weird. It wasn't funny. Like Stewie and Brian fucking entered a tennis tournament. It was weird.
Ew. Brian. Ew.
Peter.
Yeah, I was like, this isn't a good
show. Hey, Peter.
Hey, Peter. So watch a fucking like company attraction for the Squidbillies, and my sister was like, "What
I
the
love
fuck?
Fucking Squidbillies."
He was like, "What?" She was like, "What the fuck is this show?"
I'm dude, like, Squidbillies is so
I'm like,
fucking good.
Squidbillies is fucking great.
I love the fucking hats. These fucking hats are wonderful.
But anyway.
Yeah, Squidbillies. That'll be another day where we talk about.
It's the Squidbillies.
Yeah, not the Squidbillies, but maybe cartoons episodes we'll do. Maybe we'll do Adult Swim.
Yeah, we could do Adult Swim. Yeah. In the meantime,
yeah, have a wonderful holiday.
Happy holidays from us to you. Happy holidays, very happy and healthy New Year.
Happy Honda Day. Or a happy Toyota.
No, if you celebrate Toyota-thon, fuck you, you're wrong.
Your holiday's not real.
Your holiday's
a fucking joke.
We can say happy Honda Days again. Thank God. Yes. Thank Trump. Happy Honda Days.
He saved us all.
He saved us all from those Toyota-thon celebrating bastards.
He saved us all from the fucking Christmas oppression of 2012. When the economy crashed, so did Christmas.
All right.
All right,
bye guys. Merry Christmas.
Bye.